Hello, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay, after 5 minutes, your class will start. That means from 2:10. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so this is almost 2:10. So let me share the screen. Okay, so is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So in previous class, we found out the R equivalent of this circuit, right? We just did what? We did open circuit this current source, okay, and then short circuit the voltage source, and during the calculation of the R equivalent, our net circuit becomes, this is your 5, okay, since this one is short circuit and this one is your open circuit, then 2 ohm, okay, and this is your load. That means from where you have to observe, okay. So now you can see that this 2 ohm and 5 ohm are in parallel, so the calculation of R equivalent is easy. And what was the value? That is 2 parallel 5, that means simply 10/7, right? Now, according to the Norton's theorem, what we have to find out? We have to find out the short circuit current, right? Fine. Now, where is the load? Load terminal is AB. That's why across the AB, short circuiting link is done. Okay, wait just a minute. Okay, so is the screen visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine, fine. So now see here that total 2 types of sources are present here, right? So now we are going to calculate this short circuit current one source at a time. Okay, if we omit this portion, okay, step by step, try to understand. If we omit this portion first, then what will be the current direction? Our only short circuit current will flow in this fashion. Correct. That means the short circuit current flowing, when we consider only 5 ampere, is from B to A. That is the opposite direction of our ISC. So that's why we are writing that ISC2 equals to 5 ampere B to A. Is it clear? Okay. See here, our ISC direction is downward, but according to our current source, the current will flow from B to A, that means opposite direction, so that we are writing 5 ampere B to A, or we can write minus 5 ampere A to B. Clear? Okay. Now, next is the second option. We are not considering this 5 ampere. We are considering this portion, that voltage source. Okay. Now, if I consider the voltage source, then the current will flow like this. Correct? Current will flow like this. Clear? So our circuit will look like the 5 ohm. Okay, I am drawing in left hand side. Everyone check. Okay. I am not considering the 5 ampere source now. This is your short circuit path. Right? So this is your 2 volt. This is your 5 ohm. So what will be the current flow? The current flow will be simply 2/5. That means 0.4. Okay, 0.4 ampere. And the current direction is from A to B. That's why it is written that ISC1 equals to 2/5, 0.4 ampere. Clear? Now, if we combine both the circuit, then what we can say? If we combine both the parts, that means both the sources, here voltage source and the current source, then from these two circuits, we can say your total short circuit current will be ISC 1 plus ISC 2. And your direction will be from A to B. Correct. So that we are doing 0.4 plus minus of 5 ampere, because we have to check the direction also. So your current value is minus 4.6 ampere. Okay, clear? So now our equivalent circuit will look like this. Okay, we can draw also like this, the current direction, this one, right? Minus 4.6 ampere, or you can draw like this, you can write here 4.6 ampere. Both are correct. And this R internal, that means your R equivalent value is here. Okay. Is this clear to everyone? Any query?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Very good. Now, this one is the numerical. Okay. This is, see, after completion of each module, I will give you assignment. Okay, this assignment just as your homework. If you can solve this, send your snapshot in the WhatsApp group. Okay, so try this one. In next class, I will discuss this. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. So now, today we are going to learn this superposition theorem. So total two theorems we already had completed. First one, Thevenin. Second one, Norton. What are the differences? In Thevenin theorem, one, VTH, that is open circuit voltage source across the load terminal, we calculated, and in series, R equivalent is connected, then across it, the load resistance is connected. Okay, this is your load resistance. I am naming the load terminals as XY. Okay, this one is the Thevenin's theorem, according to Thevenin's theorem. Next one is the Norton's theorem. What we did? We calculated the short circuit current. Okay, this is your ISC. And in parallel, we connected the R equivalent, right? And then in parallel, we connected the RL. Okay, so here we are going to calculate the IL by current divider rule. Here we are going to calculate the current using the voltage divider rule. Okay, now this one is new, superposition theorem. Okay, so in superposition theorem, after the theoretical part, some application will be shown, and then some numerical and assignment. Okay, now this one was the previous. Okay, so what is in the superposition theorem? It states that in any linear, active and bilateral network. Do not forget these three words, linear, active and bilateral network, because if you put any unilateral element, that means the diode or that kind of device, then this superposition theorem won't be followed. Okay. Now, linear network having more than one sources, that means more than one sources mean voltage sources maybe or current sources. The response across any element is the sum of responses obtained from the each source considered separately, and all other sources are replaced by their internal resistance. Right, what does this mean? See here, take this example. Here, two sources are present, V1 and V2. Correct. So, we are going to calculate using two different circuit. In first case, we are going to consider this one first. And in second case, we are going to take or consider this second source. Okay. Now, when we consider the V1, what will happen? Look at this. I am considering only the one source, right? Look carefully. If you have any question, after the description, unmute yourself and speak, right? And what is your load part? Your load terminal is this, X and Y, right? Now, here I am going to draw the R2. And now what will happen with this voltage source? Just like the Thevenin theorem, if any voltage source is present, we are going to short circuit this. Okay. If any current source is present, we will open circuit that. Clear? That means we are going to replace by their internal resistances. Yes, any query?
The voice is not clear.
Okay, just a minute.
Sir, you are not clearly audible.
Okay, what about others? Can you hear my voice clearly?
Sir, your voice is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then maybe due to some internet problem in your device, you cannot hear me. Okay. Okay, no issue. If you cannot hear my voice, if you have any query, after this description, you can ask me. I will explain again. Right. Okay. So, one at a time, we are going to consider the sources. So, first here, check that two sources are present. One is voltage source. Another is also one voltage source. So, we are going to consider this V1 source first. Okay, so here I am considering the V1 source first. And what about the other source? That other source will be short circuited if that source is voltage source, right? And if I consider this source as current source, suppose this source is current source, then what will happen? I am going to open circuit this terminal. Okay, I will open circuit that part if that is current source. Clear. So, since it is voltage source, so no problem is there. I am short circuiting it. Clear. So, V1 is here. R1 is here. R2 is here. R3 is here. Now, can you calculate the current that will flow through this R3? Can you calculate this one? Very easy. Why? Because R3 and R2 are in parallel. Right? R3 and R2 are in parallel, and then R1 is in series. So, the total current that will flow through this section, that's from the source I1. I1 will be V1 divided by R1 plus R2 parallel R3. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So, since you know how to calculate the total current that will be the incoming current from source, now calculate the current I3. Okay, calculate the current I3. So, how can I calculate? According to current divider rule, what did I say? When we are going to calculate a current through one particular branch, we will multiply the another branch's resistance. Check here. This is your total current. Okay. I am going to multiply here R2 divided by R2 plus R3. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So that means you have remembered this one. Very good. So I3 is now present and it is going from X to Y direction. Remember the direction. It is very important. Okay, remember the direction always. So I3, fine. So this is the current calculation when V1 is considered, right? Now similar case, when V2 is considered, what will happen? When V2 is considered, let me draw the circuit. What about the V1's? What about the V1?
V1 is short circuited.
Short circuited. So I am drawing here R1. This portion will be your R3. Okay. This is your R2. Okay. And this one is your voltage source. Now, can you calculate the current I3? Can you calculate the current I3 and I2? Okay, first find out the what is the value of I2. Tell me what is the value of I2. What will be the value?
V2 by R2 plus R1 parallel R3.
Very good. R2 plus R1 parallel R3. Okay. So I2 you have calculated. Now what about this I3? Okay, I have to write here I3 dash. Okay, now fine. Just a minute. This will be I3 dash. This will be I3 double dash. Okay. So what about this I3 double dash? What will be the value? Quickly tell me.
So
I2 into R1 by R2 plus R1 plus R3.
Okay, just a minute. I2 into what about here? R1.
R1.
Divided by
R1 plus R3.
Very good. So now, using both sources, you have calculated the current, right? Now, if you combine these two sources, what will happen? Your total current I3 will be I3 dash plus I3 double dash. Always remember here the direction of current, right? Here, when I am considering the first source V1, what is the direction from X to Y? Okay, the direction is from X to Y. When we are considering the voltage source V2, what is the direction here? Check what is the direction here, that is from X to Y. So in both the cases, your current direction is same, so that whatever value you get, you can simply add them. Okay. Now, in exam, what will be given or what may be given, right? Because they are trying to give you a tricky one. How? Just a minute. Okay. Just let me erase this one. Okay. What they did, they just interchange the polarities. Okay, they just interchange the polarity. If this kind of polarity is given, then what will be the direction of current? Can you tell me? Can you tell me if the polarity of V2 is changed, then what will be the current direction?
So Y2X.
Yes,
Y2X. Y2X.
Right. That means the current direction will be from Y to X. Then what you have to do? You have to check here. You have to do what? I3 dash plus minus of I3 double dash. Why? Because your direction is just changed. Right. So if that, okay, wait a minute. Okay, so if that is given, then just take your direction and then add or subtract. No problem here. Right, so this part is explained here step by step for your better understanding. You can see here that V1 divided by R2 parallel R3. This is your R2 parallel R3. And R1 is here series. Okay, so that's why plus R1. And then here check I2 dash is calculated, or here again I3 dash is calculated. So without doing this calculation of I2 dash, you can directly calculate I3 dash. I have already shown you, right, from the current divider rule. You can directly calculate that, so that you can skip this two-step calculation. You can directly calculate the I3 using that current divider rule. Okay. Now, next one is you have to take the V2 and skip this calculation. These calculations, if you want, you can skip. You can directly calculate the I3 double dash using the current divider rule. Okay. Now, what are the steps? Already you know the steps, right? So take one only independent source at time, then calculate the each time whatever current is flowing. But remember, whenever you are considering one particular source, the other source will be short circuit if voltage source, and open circuit if current source. Right? Fine. Now, this step three, the open circuit, short circuit conditions are there. Okay. Now, what about the next one? The next one is the current calculation. All the steps are given, right? Okay. Then combine the two diagrams and calculate whatever current is there. Okay. Now, we are going to calculate the value of V using the superposition theorem. Okay. So, how can we calculate this value of V? We can calculate it either by nodal analysis. Okay. You can use the nodal analysis, or you can do it by Thevenin analysis, or you can do it by mesh analysis, or Norton, okay, or this superposition theorem. Okay, superposition theorem. So here superposition theorem is given, right? So what sources are there? What are the sources here? Total two types of sources. One is 10 volt voltage source, another one is current source. Right. So when you are considering the 10 volt voltage source, then what will happen to this current source? What will happen?
Open circuit.
Okay, fine. Then do that. This is your voltage source. Okay. This is your 5 ohm. This is your 10 ohm. And then this one is your open circuit. Now, remember, unlike the Thevenin and Norton theorem, the superposition theorem does not allow to omit your load. Are you seeing this? That here, whatever be your load terminals, X, Y, we are not omitting the load. The load is always present. Okay. So, what is the load? What is your current flowing through this circuit? Tell me, what is the current flowing through this circuit if you are considering the voltage source? Simple. These 10 and 5 are in series. Since this one is open circuit, so no current will flow through this. No current will flow, correct? So this 10 ohm and 5 ohm, total 15 ohm. So total 15 ohm means total current flow here will be I equals to 10 by 15, correct? That means this will be 2/3 ampere. Already it is done here, you can see, right? This is 2/3 ampere. Now, 2/3 ampere is flowing through 5 ohm and 10 ohm, correct? So, first current that is flowing through the 10 ohm is 2/3 ampere. Next, we have to consider this current source. So if we consider that current source, the voltage source will be shorted, correct?
Yes.
This is your 5 ohm. This one is your 10 ohm. Now, through that 10 ohm, what is the value of current? Tell me. Calculate that and tell me now. This is your 10 ohm, this is your 5 ohm. So, what is the value of current that will flow through the 10 ohm? Use the current divider rule. When I am going to calculate the current through 10 ohm, then we should multiply the 5 ohm in numerator. So, 5 into 5 divided by 5 plus 10. So that means 25 by 15. So that means 5 by 3. And what is the current direction? The current direction is from upside down, right? That means from x to y. In this case also your current direction is x to y. So what is your total current? Total current is 0.667 plus 5/3. That means 1.667. So total current you can calculate here. Okay, using superposition theorem. Now, if this much current, I am writing this one as capital A. If this capital A current is flowing through the XY branch to this 10 ohm, then what will be the voltage drop across the 10? That will be 10 into A. So voltage drop will be 10 into A, correct? And for any resistor, if current is flowing in this direction, then this side is your positive, this side is your negative, correct? Clear? So the voltage, whatever is shown in the circuit, it is correct. And the value of V is 10 into A. Okay? Clear? Okay, is there any doubt now?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, very good. Now, if in the question it is given that V's polarity is minus, this one is plus, then your total value will be total V, you have to write minus 10 A volt. Because I am telling you all the time, because in previous year exams, this kind of trick was given. Okay, so that's why I am keep on telling you that whatever be the circuit, look very carefully, because circuit is not so much complex. Circuit is very simple. That will be whatever is given in exam, circuit will be very simple. You have to look carefully every time. Okay. And just like the previous day, start solving all type of examples. If any problem is there, let me know. Okay. Now, This value is already given. Okay, now check that this value you are getting or not. Okay, this one is the numerical that will be discussed in next class. No issue. Okay, now one of you, okay, so superposition theorem is over. Now one of you just gave me one numerical. Okay, just, and I told you that I will discuss that today. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Siri, is the screen visible? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
So, I am drawing that circuit. Look whether you can understand this or not. I cannot remember that name. Okay. So, please let me know who gave me this numerical. Okay. I am just drawing this. Okay, if you are present, please let me know who gave me this numerical. This one is, I think, 20 volt. This one is 10 volt. And this one is 5 ohm, I think. Okay. This one is 10 ohm. I cannot remember clearly, but this type of numerical was given. Okay. So now you have to find what is the value of VTH. That means this open circuit is here, that is X, Y. So you have to find out what is the voltage across the X, Y.
Sir, one more okay. Resistor right there, sir.
Okay, here, no? In between this part.
Yes, sir.
What was the, what is your name?
Sir, Shubham, sir.
Shubham, okay, fine. So this is another, no?
Yes, sir.
This value is 3 ohm.
Yes, sir. And sir, 5 ohm is also 3 ohm, sir.
Okay, this one is 3 ohm.
And that one is 6 ohm, sir. 10 ohm is 6 ohm.
Okay, okay. Okay, this one is 6 ohm. Fine. So, now my question is, which process should you follow? Right. If you are trying to do the mesh analysis, then the direction problem will come again. Right. Direction problem is the current direction. Now, the better option is, as per my opinion, that you should go for nodal analysis process. Why? Because suppose in nodal analysis, one thing is very clear, that since this portion is open circuited, that means no current will flow in this process through here. No current will flow. Is that correct? And
yes, sir.
Since no current is flowing through this portion, then through this 3 ohm, no current will flow. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So, now, this one is not possible. This one is not also possible. Now, can I write here this voltage at this node? The voltage is also VTH. Can I write this? Is it okay to you? Or you cannot understand? Which one? Okay, just reply because I cannot understand which one you are thinking. See, since no current is flowing through the 3 ohm resistor, through this 3 ohm resistor, no current is flowing now. No current is flowing, so I can redraw this circuit like this. I can redraw this circuit because no current is flowing through 3 ohm. So now here the voltage is VTH. So here also the voltage will be VTH. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So this one is 6, this one is 3. Right, and I am considering that this VTH is less than 10 volt, okay, and this VTH is also less than 20 volt. And I already told you in previous class that whatever I am considering here, this does not affect your ultimate answer. Can you remember that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So this one is your 20 volt. This one is your 10 volt. Now, if VTH value is less than 20 volt, then what will be the current direction? Upward or downward? That means in this direction or in this direction? Which direction?
So downwards.
Why downward? Because VTH is less than 20 volt. This is your 3 ohm. Try to understand. This is your 3 ohm. This is your 20 volt. This one is your VTH. So VTH is higher. This one is higher. This one is lower. So which direction the current will go? From 20 to VTH. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Always think like this. That current hamesha jayega from higher voltage to lower voltage. Okay, always remember that. तो यहाँ पे VTH हो गया तुम्हारा 20 volt और 10 volt से lower. इसीलिए current हमेशा जाएगा from that source to that node. From the source to the node. Okay, that's why your current direction will be in this direction. Clear? Now, since I am considering that VTH is also less than 10 volts, so here current direction will also be in upward direction, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, what about the nodal analysis? In nodal analysis, always takes the KCL law, right? It always encounters, it always works according to the KCL law. That means total incoming current equals to total outgoing current. Now, what is here outgoing current? Can you tell me? What is your outgoing current here in this circuit? Simply zero, because all currents are incoming and your outgoing current is zero in this node. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So your incoming current is 20 minus VTH by 3, correct? Plus again incoming current 10 minus VTH by 6. Clear? What is your outgoing current? Zero. This is your outgoing current. Okay. Now calculate this one. What is your value of VTH? This is your 6. So this will be 40 minus 2 VTH plus 10 minus VTH. Okay. This is equals to 0. From here you can get 50 minus 3 VTH equals to 0. Why? Because 6 is, if multiplied with 0, that will give you 0. Now VTH value is 50 divided by 3. That means your value is 16,348. That means 16.667. Is it clear to everyone or any confusion?
Sir,
yes, clear.
Okay, yes, what confusion, please?
The outgoing current is zero, sir, how?
Because see, in this circuit, can you see any outgoing current? Because this portion is open. This portion is open. So how can you get any outgoing current?
Yes, sir.
Clear, Hua? Clear, Hua?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, whatever current you are considering here, it is your total incoming current. Two incoming currents equals to outgoing current. Your incoming current is this. This one for 20 volt source. This one for 10 volt source. And what is your outgoing current? Zero. Okay. Clear?
Yes.
So now look that your VTH value is 16.667, which is greater than 10 volt. Correct? Okay. So now if you want to take like this, okay, you are, if you are the smartest one, then you may think like this, that VTH equals to 20 volt, but hum VTH nahi lenge, jo less than 10 volt hai. I will take, I want to consider that VTH is greater than 10 volt. Okay, then how will your calculation be? Your calculation will be for this 20 volt, that will be incoming, right? So, this will be 20 minus VTH by 3. Clear? This one is your incoming current. I am writing here IC, incoming. Okay? And since you are considering VTH is greater than 10 volt, that means your current will be like this. This is your 10 volt, this is your VTH, and you have considered VTH is greater than 10. So your current direction will be this. Okay, so your current direction will be outgoing. So incoming current equals to outgoing current, and since no current is flowing through this, so it is absolute zero. Clear? So this calculation will look like VTH minus 10 divided by 6. So now you can see both equations are same, isn't it? See, I can write here like this. Right or wrong? See, both equations are same. So whatever be your consideration, your total output, whatever you are getting from the equation will remain same all the time. Clear, Hua?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So with this, I am concluding your class. Okay, just a minute. Okay, all of you give your attendance in the, okay, just let me give you the Google form link. Okay, this link will open only for 7 minutes. Okay, so within that time, submit your okay, all of you are giving your attendance here. Okay, no issue. Okay, all of you give your attendance here. From next day onwards, Google Form link will be given. Okay. And I think for F3 and F4 batch, you have the lab class today, right? From 3.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Yes.
Sir, where give Google form?
Google form for what? Attendance. You are giving your attendances. No issue.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if there is any mistake that you are present here or and I didn't give there, just let me know. Na. No issue. No problem. I will give your attendance. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, very good. So, see you in the lab for F3 and F4 batch. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.